Joining us now, Maryland's Ben Cardin. He's the ranking Democrat on the Foreign Relations Committee. Great to see you.
So, Harris, good to be with you.
I think you could hear our conversation with the White House. I know where you're standing. You might not be able to see it. But, you know, this didn't turn out the way that Democrats had probably thought the leverage would be in their corner. What happened with the shutdown? And going forward, I mean, we only have a few more days to avoid another one. What will you do?
Well, first, I didn't want a government shutdown. I don't know any Democrat who wanted a government shutdown. What we want is for us to take up the issues of a budget for our country that balances our priorities, and we want to deal with issues from health care to immigration that need to be addressed. So we do have commitments that negotiations are now ongoing to work out the budget numbers so we can have a budget for this year. We're already 4 months late. The Republicans have been unable to pass a budget. And we now have a commitment for the first time in 5 years that we're going to get an immigration bill on the floor of the United States Senate. And I am hopeful that we'll have a bipartisan, strong agreement on not only dealing with the immigration issues concerning the Dreamers, but that we will have a package that will be right for the American people.
You know, let me ask it to you this way. You said you never wanted a shutdown. Did Chuck Schumer represent you well in bringing it to that point?
Well, you know, we're in the minority. We have a limited amount of power. We understand that. But they do need our votes to get a budget done for this country. And we do want to have a budget that represents the priorities of America. So we're doing our best. We also need to deal with the immigration issue. We're trying to do our best there. And quite frankly, we now have a commitment by Leader McConnell that the United States Senate will take up an immigration bill.
You know, as we move forward, you've got the budget, you have other things that are going on besides DACA and the Dreamers. How much will you continue to tie that journey with the Dreamers to legislation to keep the government open?
Democrats don't control the schedule on the floor. Leader McConnell will do that. So it's not up to us as to what gets tied together or what opportunities we have to advance issues. We are pleased that we're working on a very tight deadline to get the budget moving and to get the immigration issues considered on the floor of the Senate. As you pointed out, there are not many days left.
No.
I was in meetings today with my Republican colleagues to try to deal with some of these issues. So there are serious discussions taking place, and I am hopeful that you will see the United States Senate do what it should do, take up an issue, debate it, and pass it.
Senator Cardin, you know, we've been in this mode of just CR, just kick the can down the road since October. Our military, we knew that you had to do something before Feb 1st because they get paid on the 1st and the 15th. So those paychecks now will still keep going in the interim. But, I mean, there's certain things that are tied all up in this, and I'm just wondering how you separate stuff out, keep the military paid while you guys argue over shutting down. And, by the way, the American public is not lost on that constitutional right that you have to continue to get paid while the military doesn't.
Right. Well, look, you cannot run government on continuing resolutions. You have to have a budget. That's what Secretary Mattis has said in regards to our national defense with the Department of Defense. They need a budget. We're now 4 months through the fiscal year that started October 1 without a budget. The Republicans control the House, the Senate, and the White House. At a minimum, they got to get a budget passed. And Democrats are prepared to work with them to make sure that we have a budget for this country. That's our top priority, whether it's the Health Department, whether it's the Department of Defense, whether it's food safety, whatever issue, the agencies need to have a full year appropriation and no more continuing resolutions.
When you hear the White House, and Hogan Gidley was just on, Deputy Press Secretary, and you see the president tweeting, how much political water did you take on with the shutdown? Because the president is calling this a win for Republicans.
Yeah, quite frankly, no one wins with a shutdown. Democrats didn't want to shut down. We believe the shutdown were caused by the Republicans. We offered so many opportunities to keep government open and negotiate the issues, including the budget. But the Republicans rejected that. They control all of the levers of power. So we believe the responsibility for the shutdown was with the Republicans and with President Trump. Having said that, we're not interested now in placing blame. We're interested in getting things done. We want a budget, and we want to deal with DACA. We want to deal with health care issues. We want to deal with opioids. We want to deal with the disaster relief. Let's get on with the business of the Senate and get things done.
How is the conversation behind the scenes? Because, you know, we got to see the curtain pulled back a couple of weeks ago today. It was only 2 weeks ago. 55-minute long meeting. And it looked like Republicans, Democrats getting along. And I'm just wondering, can you get back to that? And how important is it you have that morale on Capitol Hill that works in the favor of both?
Harris, it's very important. And quite frankly, there were very encouraging discussions taking place between Democrats and Republicans who want to see the Senate return to its regular order, that we really debate issues, take up amendments and resolve matters, that we listen to each other, and we compromise. Compromise is not a bad word. That's how our system should operate. And we need to listen to each other if we're going to be able to get that accomplished. And quite frankly, the people that participated in these discussions, there were many Democrats, many Republicans, we all agreed government shutdown makes no sense. We need to take up these issues, and we need to debate these issues and resolve these issues.
Senator Cardin, before I let you go, how is it, and I hear what you're saying, and it sounds a lot like what Republican leadership has said, too, we're all going to get along, a big kumbaya, a big hug at the end. But the fact of the matter is, the president has talked about the wall since the campaign. Americans, when you poll them, they understand the issues along our border and how the president means wall system. So you've got part wall, more border security, you've got a four-pronged approach. How is it then today your leadership and Chuck Schumer says, I'm taking the money that I had previously said that we would give off the table? What do you say about that?
Well, quite frankly, a wall has limited value from the point of view of keeping our border safe.
No, I said system, and I quoted what the White House has been saying.
And Democrats support that. We support border
security. So why take the money off the table?
No, border security is on the table. We will talk border security. There's needs for better technology. There's a lot of things we can do. Democrats want to keep our borders safe. So border security is clearly on the table.
All right. So when Schumer says I'm taking that $1.6 billion off for the wall, that's part of that system. I just want to be clear when you say you're going to get along, because that's a key component.
I think what the president was asking in that meeting was specifically money designated for a wall. And that has been a controversial issue because there's many of us who believe that it has limited value in keeping our borders safe. Having said that, we're sitting down and we're going to negotiate.
There you go. There it is, working together,
Absolutely.
Senator Cardin.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for your
My
time.
My pleasure. Thank you, Harris.